Listen up, Grunts. It's time to make our new unit goals for the next year. We want to really impress the top brass. So we need to show big troop surges and completely dominate our territory with new units moving in.
Sir? That sounds like a great idea, sir. What sort of goal are you thinking about, sir?
Well, we want to be really impressive. And our mission is of utmost importance. So I was thinking we should double the unit. Double the unit. We need more troops. Let's get busy.
Double, sir?
Yes, double it.
Do you have a plan on how to double it? That's a pretty tall order. I've never seen that sort of growth, sir. Any, that sort of sustainable growth, anyway.
Well, you can figure that out, can't you?
Well, surely it would be more prudent to take a strategic look at where our weaknesses were and make a plan to form a new unit where it can do the most good. That way, we can put the most effort into fortifying those positions the best we can, so that these new units can perform at the highest level possible and survive the test of time, so we don't have to keep coming back year after year to replenish these units with leadership. Unit retention is important, right, sir?
First,
well, that is right, Lieutenant. How can we be more strategic in our plan?
Well, for starters, I've prepared a map of our district and plotted all the population centers, elementary schools, and special areas of interest, as well as the locations of our current units, making note of their type, unit strength, and any special notes that might go along with these.
Interesting. Tell me more.
Yes, sir. Well, you can see that we have units here, and here, here, and here, and here. Our Western's front is very strong, but there's a big lack of any units in this population area. There's a big lack of any units to serve these population areas. Nothing at all. One or two strong units here would make a vast improvement on the level of service that we can provide. And since we know that we can do the most good here, this is where we can put most of our efforts to yield the best results and to start new units that will be strong here in 5, 10, maybe even 20 years in the future.
Sounds great, Grunt. What else you got?
Well, we also have an opportunity up here in the Northeast, sir. It's a major population center, but we only have a few types of units. There are no venture crews for the older recruits to participate in. We already have a dedicated charter partner here for our other units, so it might be a natural fit for them to go pick up another unit with a ready population to go into these units.
Okay. Any other ideas?
Yes, you can see the pack over here has a huge population center, but the unit itself is not as big as it possibly could be. It appears they only tend to put a lot of effort into recruiting from one school, but their other school they recruit from doesn't get very much attention from their recruiters. We could possibly start a unit here and support the school that gets neglected.
Looks like you have a plan, Lieutenant.
Well, thank you.
Let's get going. Start planning your sales calls.
Oh, yes, sir, yes, sir. But my counts will need to have 4 units to be successful, so I'll prepare that list of prospects for you right away.
Excellent, excellent. Get me these 4 prospects ASAP.
Oh. Four prospects, sir? No. We'll need more prospects than that. There's a general rule that 2 out of every 3 of our prospects will not be a good fit. So if we want 4 units, then we'll need at least 12 good prospects to have the best shot of reaching our goal. I can have that for you, PDQ, sir.
Excellent. Great work, Grunt. Get to it. Now, for the rest of you, get to it. We'll need you to give a report on your strategic opportunities and a report on your prospects for these units. Hop to it, Grunt. Hop, 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 hop. Ooh-ah.
Okay.